Factor trinomials like ax squared plus bx plus c, where a is equal to 1. So these examples, we have x squared, and you see coefficient of x squared is 1 in all the cases. So these are special cases. When the coefficient of x squared is 1, then for factoring, we can adopt product and sum method. Product and sum really means that we are looking for two numbers whose product is this number 12, and sum is the center number, that is coefficient of x. So we are looking for two numbers p and q, for example, whose product is equal to c and whose sum is equals to b, the coefficient of x. So if we get this combination of numbers, then we can very easily factor such trinomials. So I'll show you how. Let's go through them one by one. So the very first one is x squared plus 8x plus 12. Here, we're looking for a product of 12. So the two numbers which could give us product of 12 could be, and we need sum of 8. For example, 4 times 2, 4 times 3 is 12, right? But 4 plus 3 is not 8. So the two magic numbers which will give us 12 are, let's say, p times q, which will give us 12, are 6 and 2. When you add these two, that means if you add p and q, you get 8. So that will satisfy our condition. So if you get this set of numbers, then only you can factor. So you can factor this, since we know 6 times 2 is 12 and 6 plus 2 is 8, I can write this as x plus 6 times x plus 2. So that is how we factor them. Now to test it out, you can always expand and check whether you get back your numbers or not. Let's do the next one. Here we are looking for two numbers whose product is minus 12, right? So we are looking for two numbers with product of minus 12. And sum of, that is p plus q of 4. So the numbers could be, if you have product of minus 12, that means one of them is positive and the other one is negative. So this time, still the numbers are 6 and 2, but the bigger number is positive, that is plus 6 and minus 2. When you add plus 6 and minus 2, you get plus 4. So here, the answer is x plus 6 times x minus 2. These are our two magic numbers. Do you get it? Let's go through it once again with another example. The example here is x squared plus 7x plus 6. Now we are looking for two numbers whose product is 6. And when you add them, you get 7. So the number could be 6 times 1. When you add them, you get 7, correct? So we could write this as x plus 6 times x plus 1. Last one on this list. Now here, in this list, I have taken all these b coefficients as positive. Now when I am taking this b coefficients as positive, then when I do product, the bigger number has to be positive, right? Now this one, we are looking for product of 15 minus. So p dot q equals to minus 15, and p plus q is 14 for us. So the two numbers should be 15 and 1. And out of which, 15 should be positive, 1 should be negative, correct? When you add them, you get plus 14. When you multiply them, you get minus 15. So minus means opposite sign, and plus means higher one with positive. So that is how we get our numbers. So we get here x plus 15 times x minus 1. I hope you have learned the technique of factoring trinomials where the leading coefficient is 1. Let's apply it once more in the next video. Thank you.